Hello and welcome to today's Ledgeview Dynamics CRM User Group webinar, Highlighting Dashboards. My name is Christina Felchlin, Support Manager at Ledgeview, and I'll be your host. This user group is for all customers who are looking for answers about how do I or what is the best way to. You, the users, are driving the content for these groups. By submitting your questions at registration, it allows us to provide the best answer to you as well as the other attendees who may have similar questions. Before I introduce today's presenter, I have just a couple of housekeeping items to cover. First, today's webinar is being recorded and will be available on demand after the live session. All registered attendees will receive an email this afternoon with an access link. Along with that link, you will receive the registration for the next 6 months of Ledgeview Dynamics CRM webinars. We have a lot of content to cover today, but we'd love to hear from you during today's presentation. To ensure the best audio quality for all the attendees, we have everyone in listen-only mode. If you have a question, please submit those in the question pane for your GoToWebinar control panel. We will address as many questions as we can at the end, and if time does not permit, we will follow up offline. Like I mentioned earlier, the best way to submit a question is when registering for the webinars. This will allow us to incorporate them into our presentation. We have a lot to cover today, so let's get started. I'm pleased to introduce today's speaker, Michael Dodd, Support Consultant with Ledgeview Partners.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining our second user group webinar. I'm very excited to announce that we're going to be talking about dashboards today. Before we get started, I wanted to have us take a poll just to gauge everyone's experience with dashboards, just so we have a better understanding. So thank you guys very much for taking the poll, as it'll just help us drive the content for today. And I see that the majority of everyone is they either use dashboards frequently or are not very experienced with them. So without further ado, let's get started. Today's agenda is we're going to talk about dashboard tips, dashboard scenarios, and then we're going to go over the great user questions that everyone submitted. Tips to make your dashboard effective. A big piece to dashboards is making them simple to use. You're going to be using them every day. You want to make sure they're simple, easy to get into, easy to understand, and able to move on with your day. You want to make them relevant with information that you're going to be viewing each day. So business performance, success indicators to understand how well you're doing or your users are doing, and most importantly is the role of you as the user. How does it apply to you? You want to make sure they're focused. If you have multiple charts, you want to make sure they're focused on one area. That way you're going into the dashboard understanding what you're looking at. They also need to save time. It needs to be a one-stop shop. You need to go in, get all the information you need for your day, and then be able to move on. You're going to be using these dashboards every day. You need to give yourself a reason to come back often and view them. Thus, the importance of being focused and relevant with business information. Like we discussed last week in keeping advanced fines, or last month, like we discussed keeping advanced fines clean, keeping your dashboards clean is just as important. You want to make sure you're removing charts and lists that are no longer useful or have important information and update them with more useful charts. And sharing your dashboard is great for coworkers in a similar role. That way you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Today we're going to talk about a few different scenarios. I'm going to go over and show you how to do a couple of them, but then I will show you the rest of the dashboard scenarios in a pre-created dashboard. So our first scenario today is what is my opportunity estimated revenue? And we're going to break that down by sales stage. Then we're going to do a look ahead at what is closing the next month, broken down by estimated revenue. Then we can also look at open leads generated in the last week, an activity to-do list sorted by priority, and an annual revenue department broken down by department. So without further ado, let's go ahead and build these dashboards. And everything you see today is going to be in CRM 2015 Update 1. So if you're on CRM 2013 or a lower version, these are all still available. They're still in the same location. It's just navigating to those pieces will be a little bit different. So within CRM 2015 update one, we're going to go to sales and go to dashboards. I apologize for that error. Let me jump back here. I apologize for the technical difficulties. Let me just log back out and log back in. I apologize. And sometimes this will happen. The key part with Dynamics is not to panic and just start your session back over, and we're going to go ahead and get everything rolling here today. So I'm going to bring our dashboards back up. And again, by navigating to sales and then to dashboards, and we're going to work on creating a new dashboard. But before we even get to the dashboard step, we want to make sure that we're creating our charts within the view that we're looking to show in the dashboard. So for example, we're looking at opportunities. So we need to navigate from sales to opportunities. And we want to look at my opportunities, because as a salesperson or as a user, you're interested in your specific information. So we navigate to the view that we'd like, and then to create a chart, we simply go over here to this right-hand side by the charts, click on the list, and it's going to pop out a chart section for us. We want to create a new chart, so we're going to click on this plus sign. And then we want to create our chart, and we are looking at our estimated revenue, and then we want to see that broken down by stage. So on the vertical axis, we're going to put estimated revenue, and on the horizontal axis, we're going to put sales stage. So I'm going to navigate within our list to sales stage. And in the chart designer, it actually already came up with a great title for us, which is estimated revenue by sales stage. So I simply click save. It's going to come up, pop up the name to make sure we want it saved. We're going to click save again. And now we have our chart created. The next piece that we're looking for of the chart that we wanted to create is a look ahead of what is closing in the next month and then broken down by estimated revenue. So I'm going to scroll down to a view that I created like we did last week or last month in our advanced find. I'm going to do opportunities closing in the next 30 days. I'm going to once again create a chart. And I'm basically looking to understand what is our estimated revenue. And that's going to go on our vertical axis. And then I'm going to look at topic for our horizontal axis. So that way it'll tell me the title of the opportunity and the amount of revenue that is estimated. And then we click save again. Save the chart and close. Now that we have our charts created, we want to go back to sales and go to dashboards. And because we're creating a new dashboard, we're going to go into the section where it shows like chart, new. For dashboards, there's six different layouts that we can choose from. The most amount of charts slash lists that you can put into a dashboard is six. And this one happens to be the most common, the three-column regular dashboard. So we're going to select that and click Create. We're going to want to start off with naming our dashboard. So we're going to name this Test Dashboard 1. And in our first section, when we want to insert charts, we go into this chart look with the plus sign. And we're going to insert our first chart that we created, which was in the opportunity record type. Our view is my open opportunities, since we're only interested in what we own as opportunities. And then our chart was estimated revenue by sales stage. Then we click add, and it's going to add our chart. Then we have our next chart that we created, which was the look ahead, which was also in opportunities. But the view was different. The view was the opportunities closing in the next 30 days. So we want to make sure we create the correct view, and then do chart, estimated revenue by topic. And then click add. And as you can see here in our estimated revenue by topic, it's going to show opportunities closing in the next 30 days, and then the topic name and how much revenue we're expecting. That's perfect for if your sales manager is coming to you and he wants to know what opportunities of yours are going to be closing. You can simply direct him to your dashboard, and he has all the information right there. Lastly, I'm going to show you how to insert a list. So we're going to go to this list icon, check that, and one of our scenarios was to look at open lead generated within the last week. So our record type is going to be leads, and we created a view called leads generated in the last 7 days. Then we click add. As you can see here, this looks blank. That is going to show blank until we save and close our dashboard. So now that we have it saved, we simply click close. And I'm going to navigate over to our dashboard that we created for this webinar. And this will show all of our scenarios. So as you can see here, leads generated in the last 7 days. Once you save and close your dashboard, you can bring it up and it's going to show your list. And that's going to simply reflect your view. So every column and filter criteria that you put in your view is now going to show in your dashboard. If you don't want to have to scroll all the way over, you can simply click this list icon up top here, and it'll bring up a separate window of that view. The other dashboard that we created, the other items within the dashboard that we created, were the activity to-do list sorted by priority. This is very important, so you can simply go into your dashboard to see what activities you need to work on for the day. Click on your first one and work on your activity. Our last scenario was annual revenue by department breakdown. So this will show all of your active accounts, and it'll break down the revenue by department. So each account has a separate department, and you can see how your revenue is doing. And that's our dashboards. So to go back to our PowerPoint, a very complicated way of doing dashboards is to insert what's called an iframe. I've included the steps here of how to do an iframe. We're not going to touch on this, as this is a more complex dashboard scenario, but if you do decide that you'd like to insert an iframe into your dashboard and you need assistance, that would be a great use of your ad hoc support agreement, and we would be happy to help you here at Ledgeview Partners. The main use of an iframe is to be able to expand the number of charts or lists that you can insert into a dashboard. It's a way of embedding an already created dashboard into a new dashboard. Before we start on our questions, we had a lot of great questions submitted today, and with the limited time of our webinar today, I'm going to touch on each question briefly so we have an answer to each one. But if you find it interesting or want more information on it, please feel free to contact Ledgeview Support in use of the ad hoc support agreement, and we'd be happy to answer these questions for you. Our first question is, how do we create a view with different records that have the same information and included on a dashboard? For example, duplicate opportunities. This is a fantastic question, and it would be a great use of CRM. The best way to do this is to use customization, in which you would use a grab of a duplicate detection job and then pull that into a dashboard to display. That way you would be able to see your duplicate opportunities or leads, however you set the duplicate detection job up. But it would need customization. Our next question is, how do you use the list feature in a dashboard, and what is it useful for? Best part about a list, as we showed in our scenario, is you can show any view within dashboard. Any advanced find that you turned into a view can be made into a dashboard. So, for example, users' activities due today, as we used in our scenario, users' opportunities closing in the next 30 days. That way you have an idea as a salesperson what revenue you have coming in. And also, users' contacts that have not been contacted in over 3 months. If they haven't been contacted, you know that's an activity that you're going to need to jump on to keep engaged with those contacts. For our next question, I'm actually going to show a demonstration on this, but our question is, how do I set up goals so as to have a dashboard that can reflect data showing in a graph form? For example, percent achieved, loss versus won, total 1 year to date, etc. I'm going to leave these steps up here, but we're going to go through them right now. So to start off with, we're going to want to create a goal. So if we go to sales, we go over to goals. Then we're going to want to create a new goal, so click new. Start off with, we need to name our goal. Goal owner, in this case it's going to be myself, and then our goal metric, which is very important, and we're going to use revenue. If your goal metric does not exist, the item that you're looking to show a goal for, you want to make sure you go in and create a goal metric. That is something, again, that Ledgeview Partners can help you with. Next piece we're going to want to touch on is, you want to focus this in on a time period. You can do it for a year, a quarter, a month. You can set this to however you'd like it to be. It sets fiscal periods, but you can also change it to a custom period. For our example, we're going to use quarter four of fiscal year 2015. Then you're going to set your target. In this case, we're looking at revenue. So my target for myself is to have $200,000 in revenue in quarter four of this fiscal year. As you can see, this actuals is actually grayed out. So we're going to save our goal. And then we're going to click recalculate. And it's going to say the data roll up will take some time. So what this is doing is it's taking all the data from our revenue that we've generated in the time frame, and it's going to calculate it together. As we pull down here, 172,000. So I've done a pretty good job towards my goal. Granted, quarter four is coming to an end, but I'm already at 86%. So then we click save and close. We're just going to refresh. And as you can see, all of this information has now shown in our goals, in our view. The second part of that question was to create a chart that can be used in a dashboard. So then we'll just go over here to chart, click on new. And for our field, we are going to look at our percentage achieved, and the name of our target. So simply it's going to say for our test goal, we are sitting at 86% achieved. You can also change this to show the amount of revenue you've achieved throughout the year, in which case it would show 172,000. You would again save this chart, click save. And then you would add it to the dashboard just as we showed in our scenario. For our next question, how do I create dashboards to show progress? This is definitely dependent on what you're looking to show progress for, but an example would be the goals scenario that we just set up, and you can refer to the previous slide for that information. Really great question was, create an administrator dashboard. What types of things would be good to be monitoring? So again, you would create the dashboard the same way we did in our scenarios. But some really good ideas that administrators have used are a list of your active users, user adoption, so looking at the number of logins per day, per month, whichever breakdown you'd like to. View of the mailbox setup for each user. For example, if you're using server-side sync or an email router, you can use this to view what each user is on in case you have different users that are in different types of mailbox setup. List of your active workflows. As an administrator, you're usually going to be in charge of those workflows and making sure they're working correctly, so a dashboard showing you those would be very helpful. List of your duplicate detection rules. Mostly you're going to want to look at the published ones. So if you have a view of that, you can keep track of which ones are in need of being updated or if they need to be unpublished. And then you can show a chart of custom reports versus out-of-the-box reports. That will really show you how you've broken down, if you really needed to customize CRM or if you're using it more as an out-of-the-box scenario. Another question is, how do I make it faster? This is really quite dependent on what you're looking to make faster and on different factors. It can come down to internet speed, the amount of data being loaded, for example, in charts or in reports. If you're loading a lot of data, it will take a longer amount of time because CRM is processing so much information. Ledgeview Partners is, we'd be happy to be a resource to help you figure out what that is. How do I set up email out of CRM? There are a few different ways to do this. One of them is to utilize an email blast with campaigns and quick campaigns. You can also look to integrate Click Dimensions or Acton into your CRM org. These are third-party products that are really great at being able to send emails directly from CRM. You can also use the Outlook client to track or set regarding emails. So if you have an email that comes in or you're sending out, you can track them, and then you can use the set regarding to show it within CRM as an activity. How do I create an email blast? There are three crucial steps. First one is to create a marketing list, and there are two types of marketing lists. There's a dynamic marketing list and a static marketing list. A static marketing list is a group of people that does not change unless you remove or add individuals. Dynamic pulls all the people that meet a specific criteria, kind of like an advanced find, and pulls them into the marketing list, and it can constantly change as you're adding new users or new contacts or accounts. You would then utilize a quick campaign or campaign to generate the email blast. The main difference between a quick campaign and a campaign is quick campaign is really used for one type of thing, either a mailing list, an email blast, really do only one thing. Where a campaign, you can use multiple different marketing strategies, so an email blast and a mailing list, etc. So everyone is aware, we are going to have a marketing specific user group webinar in the month of March, so stay tuned for that with more information. Another question on Dynamics CRM 2011 regarding charts. This user would like to create a dashboard that has many charts, approximately 20 to 25, and they're wondering if it's possible in Dynamics CRM 2011. This is definitely possible, but the only way to do this is with an iframe. So as we discussed, an iframe is a way to embed an existing dashboard into a newly created dashboard. So if you're looking for 20 to 25, you're going to have multiple existing dashboards that you're going to embed using iframe. And you can go up to 6. embedded dashboards. Without an iframe or a different type of customization, you are limited to 6 charts or lists in a single dashboard. As we showed in our scenario, we only had 6 open slots to add information. How do I know the differences and capabilities between my views and system views? That's a fantastic question. System views are available to everyone and do not need to be shared. They're either created by an administrator or they come out of the box. And they can only be changed in the customization and configuration section. My views are views that you created, and they're only available to you and those you've shared the view with. They are editable with an advanced find, as we did in our last webinar, by editing columns. You can really customize them to how the information you'd like them to be, where a system view is set up by another user for something that's going to work for everyone. How do I sum numbers in a dashboard? As we saw in our scenarios, and just to go a little bit deeper into this, a dashboard is simply a reflection of a created chart or view. It's taking that information and putting it into one location. There is a way around this, and steps to complete this would be to create a chart for the sum value you're looking for. And what I mean by that is, if you want to look at estimated revenue for your opportunities, you can create a chart that just shows your total estimated revenue for all of your opportunities. Then by clicking on the dashboard or clicking on the chart, you can drill deeper and pull out all the different topics and how much their revenue is for each different topic of opportunity. You can add this chart to the dashboard, and you can also do the drill down within the dashboard. How do I make a bar graph, including a bar totaling the other bars? This is very similar to the last question, where you would create a chart that shows the total amount and then drill down within that chart to show a further breakdown. Unfortunately, without customization, having an included bar graph showing the total is not possible without that customization, but this is a great way around that. It doesn't require any customization. How do I extract data for analysis? There are 3 really key ways to export data to Excel for analysis, and those are creating an advanced find for a specific subset of data, just like we did in our last webinar. And if you have questions or you want to re-review that, we do have that recording available. Personal and system view. So any type of view, you can export that data to Excel and do different types of data analysis. You can also create a report. So any report that you've created or is existing within CRM, once you run the report, you could export that data to Excel to dive a little deeper. How do I create new charts for public dashboards? Part of this goes back to our scenario. So to create a new chart, you just navigate to the view you wish to create a chart for, click on charts, and then click on the plus sign. Now the key difference here is once the chart is created, you're going to want to navigate to customization and configuration within the settings sections of CRM. You'll click on dashboards, then you're going to open the dashboard you wish to add the chart to, and then simply insert your new chart or remove an old chart and add the new one. When will the 2016 version be out? And if we are in the process of upgrading to 2015, should we jump to 2016? This is a fantastic question. I want to start off with 2016 is looking to be available in the Q4 of 2015. We don't have a specific date at this time. I'm going to touch on a few highlights of 2016. So, for example, mobile app management with Intune is a new step within 2016. It's going to be an updated release for the Microsoft CRM app for Outlook. That's not to be confused with the CRM Outlook client, which is the add-in. They're integrating Delve, which is a new Office 365 piece, and it's going to integrate that functionality within CRM. is going to be better integration between Office apps and CRM apps, many improvements for mobile users, and a really key piece for all of us is tighter integration for Office, SharePoint, OneDrive for Business, and Office 365. So key, really key components for Microsoft, you're going to have great integration with those for CRM. You're also going to have offline mobile capabilities. In regards to the second part of their question about being in the process of upgrading to 2015, should we jump to 2016? We highly recommend discussing this, your CRM needs with your company and making a decision from there. Ledgeview Partners is happy to be a resource for the upgrade.
Thanks, Michael. Well, we are out of time. We actually are 1 minute over, so I just want to have a brief closing here, but I do want to invite all of you guys to a webinar about Dynamics CRM 2016. You can go to our website and click on News and Events, and there you will see a list of our webinars, and you can register for the What's New with Dynamics CRM 2016, as well as check out the other listings and our on-demand webinars. So from all of us at Ledgeview, we just want to say thank you and hope you have a great holiday. And again, you will receive the link to the recorded session here and registration for the upcoming series. Hope you have a great day. Thanks for attending.